Say, what is the last question?
Explain why H2O is having higher boiling point than HF, even though HF has 8 bond strength.
Right. Next question. A metal polyhalide, RbIcl2, on decomposition, what are the products obtained? If the question is whether the metal is added to lower halide or higher halide, this is decomposing. Definitely, it will decompose to what RbI and RbCl2, definitely. RbI, RbCl2, or maybe RbI again, RbCl again, or ICl again. Yeah, then the Rb is generally added to more electron into halogen, then remaining again, ICl. So these are the products. It means what? Metal is added to more electron negative halogen, but not to the less electron negative halogen on decomposition. That is the product. Take the products and write the point. A metal polyhalide, take the reaction, complete it. A metal polyhalide on decomposition, metal is added to a halogen with a high electron negativity. Freshly distilled, aqueous HI is colorless. On long standing, it slowly turns to brown. Explain. Pani Teja, are you there in the class? Pani Teja?
Yes, sir.
Can you answer this? Freshly prepared. Aqueous HI is colorless, but actually your storing slowly turns to brown. Can you say what? What is the reason?
Sir, 1 minute, sir. Sir, don't know, sir.
Right. So, you bring aqueous HI. When you are actually storing, of course you are closing, but little amount of air will be there in the closing vessel also. By that, undergoes aerial oxidation. A it is nothing but water, O2, aerial oxidation. And once it is undergoing oxidation, then you are getting what? Slowly I2 is formed. I2 plus H2O you're getting. I2 in a H2O will be brown. I2 in a H2O will be brown. Therefore, slowly it turns to brown to the formation of iodine by the aerial oxidation of H2O. Right. It is due to aerial oxidation of H I to iodine. 4 H I plus A O2, then actually I2 2 I2 plus H2. I2 in a water is what wrong. It is due to formation of iodine, it turns to brown. Next. Iodine is almost insoluble in water. Iodine is almost insoluble in water. But in presence of KI, its solubility increase. Explain. Come on, all of you, try. Is it there in the notes? Mayank, are you there in the class? Mayank.
Yes, sir.
Can you answer this? Iodine is insoluble in water. But to put KI, solubility increase. Why? Can you answer, Mayank?
I don't know, sir.
Are you getting an idea? I give a clearly there in the notes. Iodine is insoluble in water. It is soluble only just 5 to 10%. Very, very less soluble or insoluble. But to add KI, KI reacts with iodine, produce KI3. Due to formation of a complex KI3, the solubility of iodine in water increases. Right. It is due to formation of KI3 or I3 minus. KI3 or I3 minus. Next. Cesium-5-iodine is stable. Cesium-5-iodine is stable, but sodium-5-iodine is less stable. Explain. Trisha, can you answer this? Cesium iodide is stable. Trisha, you are there in the class? Trisha. You are there, but you are not responding. Okay, leave it. Trisha, you are there in the class? Bhanutej? Are you there in the class?
Yes, sir.
Can you answer this? Cesium iodide is stable, but sodium iodide is less stable. Can you answer?
No, sir.
No. So what you are observing, the difference, are you observing any difference between these two? Any difference?
No, sir.
See, bigger cation stabilizes bigger anion and vice versa. There should be two bigger. Because at first year group I used to give you, bigger cation, bigger, more stable, smaller, bigger, less stable.
Yes, sir.
Bigger anion, stable. This is what smaller cation. Bigger anion. I came is very big. It's very big. This is small. But both are big. Big, stable. Small, big, less stable. That's all. That's the answer. Come on. Bigger cation stabilizes. Bigger cation stabilizes. Bigger cation stabilizes bigger anion. Bigger anion and vice versa. And vice versa. And vice versa. Therefore, cesium triiodide is more stable. Cesium triiodide is more stable, and sodium triiodide is less stable. Right. What is flotane? This question has been many times in another exam. What is flotane? What is flotane? What for it is used? What is flotane? What for it is used? Everybody has to respond whether you are there or not. Once you are there, you have to respond compulsory. Once I am calling you, you respond. If you do not answer, you do not answer. How can you answer? How can you know all the questions I am asking you? It's not possible. What is the need? Come on, sir. What is flotane? What is the importance of this? Anybody know this flotane? Flotane, very important compound. Right on. CF3CHBrCl. CF3CHBrCl is flotane. CF3CHBrCl is flotane. Something like this. This is flotane. This is flotane. What is the importance of this? Question number many times under the exam. Right. It is used as anesthetic. Formula of flotane is this one. And it is used as an anesthetic. CF3, CHBrCl. Remember, it is used as an anesthetic. Next. What are super acids? What are super acids? Super acids. Super acid. Anybody? Super acid. Did you listen any time? Super acids.
No, sir.
No.
Sorry.
Super acid means it should be highly capable of accepting a big acid. It should be highly capable of donating a H plus acid. Right. Now, SBFI. SBFI and fluorosulfuric acid. Yeah. SO3H. These two are super acids. These two are super acids. Super acids. Write a point here. SBFI. Why is it super acid? SBFI is a powerful electron pair acceptor. Powerful electron pair acceptor. Did you go ready? Are you writing or not?
Yes, sir.
Huh? Next. SBFI is a powerful electron pair acceptor. Next. This is fluorosulfuric acid. Fluorosulfuric acid. FSO3H is a powerful proton donor. Therefore, these two are commonly called as super acids. Super acids. One more question. Think carefully. Try to answer all of you. Which of the following never undergo disproportionation? Which of the following never undergo disproportionation? Think carefully. Answers. Third only. Two, three, four. Two, three, four. Two, three, four. One, two, three. One, two, three. One, three. Among these, with rather undergo disproportionation. No chance for disproportionation. Risha, you are there in the class? Risha? Risha?
Sir.
Are you there in the class?
Yes, sir.
So why you are not responding last time?
Actually, I did not heard properly.
Huh? You have to respond compulsory. You are sitting in the class, you have to respond. Otherwise, get out. Try to answer this. All of you try, 2 minutes I am giving. Among the which doesn't undergo DPN, disproportionation. Risha, try to answer. All of you try. Think carefully, you can easily answer it. You know what is disproportionation, so that you can easily make it. Don't see the answers. First you pick out your answer, then see the answers. Don't see the answers, you won't get anything in answers. First you see, whether they can undergo DPN or not, then see the answer. Trisha, can you answer? Are you getting an idea or not?
No, sir.
No, leave it. Anybody can answer this? The recent question, the question from the recent exam. Saitej, can you think carefully?
Sir, D.
Sir, don't know, sir.
No, no, not getting. Any other?
Sir, D.
Answer, anybody?
D. Option D.
D.
D is the answer? D is the answer?
Yes, sir, I think.
D means chlorine, no? D means chlorine, and again, H2S. H2S, correct answer. Look, all of you, what is DPN? Come on, say, all of you. You know, DPN and ND, all of you.
Sir, oxidation reduction. Yeah.
Undergo oxidation reduction. You know, chlorine can never form any compound with the F+. There is no chance for F+. F is always minus only, no plus compound. Chlorine never undergoes oxidation. It may undergo reduction, but it never undergoes oxidation. There is no chance for chlorine undergoing DPN. Leave it. Let's go down again. What about 3? 3 and 3, H2S law. H2S law, what is the oxygen number of sulfur? H2S law, what is the oxygen number of sulfur? S-2. So it has to undergo reduction and oxidation. Reduction and in Japan, it has to undergo reduction means, what should it happen? It reduce power and ignoring. S-2 has to be reduced into ఏం కావాలి?
హలో
ఏం కావాలి? రిడ్యూస్ కావాలంటే ఏం కావాలి?
S-2 కావాలి సార్.
S-2 కావాలి. ఏం కావాలి? ఆక్సిజన్ పెరగాలా తగ్గాలా?
పెరగాలి సార్.
పెరగాలి. పెరగాలి.
పెరగాలా తగ్గాలి? తగ్గాలంటే -2 has to become -3. అంతే కదా?
అదే సార్. -3 అవ్వాలి.
-2 has to become S-3. S-3 ఉంటదా? మనకి నచ్చదా?
లేదు సార్.
S-3 ఉంటదా? ఉండదు. నో ఛాన్స్. S-1 మే బి దే, S-2 మే బి దే, బట్ S- ఇస్ నాట్ దేర్. నో ఛాన్స్ అట్ ఆల్. సెకండ్ ఏ గ్రూప్ ఎలిమెంట్ నెవర్ ఫార్మ్ ఎనీ S-3 అయాన్స్. దేర్ ఇస్ నో ఛాన్స్ అట్ ఆల్. ఓకే, సో ఇట్ కెన్ నెవర్ బి రిడ్యూస్డ్. కానీ ఇట్ కెన్ బి ఆక్సిడైజ్డ్ అట్ నాట్.
ఆక్సిడేషన్
కావాలి.
S minus 1.
S minus kawachu, it may become S0 kawachu, right?
Yes,
it may become S minus, it may become S0. Oxidation is possible, but reduction is not possible. Right? Therefore, the first term 3. Then come to this point. HNO2. What is the oxidation number of nitrogen? What is the oxidation number of nitrogen?
D, sir.
Plus 3. So plus 3 can become, nitrogen oxygen is plus 3, nitrous acid.
Yes, sir.
Nitrogen can become 0, nitrogen can become plus 3 can become plus 4, plus 5. Nitrogen can become plus 3 to plus 4, plus 4 to plus 5, there is a chance. And nitrogen plus 3 may become plus 1 or plus 2 or 0. So it can undergo oxidation or reduction. There is possibility. Here in this, M is what? Plus 3. N plus 3 can become N plus 4, N plus 5. And it can become N plus 1, N plus 2, N 0. So, oxidation, reduction, possible. Then, what about SO2? What is the oxygen number of sulfur?
Plus 4, sir.
Plus 4. It becomes plus 4 only. In the sulfur is plus 4. So, it can become plus 5 power 2, plus 6 power 2. And it can become plus 2, plus 3. So here oxidation, here reduction.
Yes.
But here S minus 2 cannot become S minus 3. So you should have this particular knowledge, otherwise you cannot answer this question from the recent exam. Okay, how to do it? What is the actual BPN? You have to put on the paper and carefully check it. Oxidation reduction possible for each element or not? Accordingly, you have to answer. The questions are coming like this. You have broad knowledge, otherwise very difficult. So answer is what B. So these two can undergo DPN, but these two cannot undergo DPN. Our and the actual is the Rasputa and the Rasputa. Explanation Rasputa, Manamir open is the Ramiko. If put in the explanation in China, mentally Rasputa, Paku Rasputa, otherwise you cannot understand Platon. Question adding up to respond around it. You need not say, in Adita Pandani, your answer is Nakaledo. You need not know, how can you may ask me a doubt? I may not answer. How can I be? I am not 100% perfect, no. You too also, right? This end is possible, but this end is not possible. Answer it, D. Very good question. See, very, very good question. Simply by looking, you cannot answer. Put on the paper, how to analyze and how to say the answer. I too also, by looking that, I cannot answer easily by looking whether it will undergo or not. I will put on the paper what is the oxygen number and decrease and increase is possible or not. Then accordingly, how to decide? I cannot even answer within a minute that one. I will go analyze at least for 2-3 minutes, then only I can answer it. This is not possible. Completed, shall I remove?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
The questions are appearing like this. Simple questions are very rare. By this type of questions, you are answering 2-3 questions, you are answering like this. You dominate. By one question, you are answering correct, and your rivaling student is not doing correctly, and you can actually overcome 1 lakh students. One question, you can overcome 1 lakh of students. One question you are doing correct, other is not doing correct, then you can overcome nearly 1 lakh of students. That's the thing. Right. Come on, where you stop our regular class? Yes. Right.
Xenon oxyfluoride, sir.
Right. Xenon oxy?
Fluoride. Structure was done, sir.
Xenon OF to computation, aren't you,
no? Ah, sir.
Structure would happen, sir.
I think, sir.
అయితే ఓపెన్ ఇవ్వాలి జినాన్ F4 జినాన్ F4 ఓపెన్ చేయండి వన్ ఆర్ టూ రియాక్షన్ మిస్సింగ్ దే జినాన్ F4 ఓపెన్ చేయండి ఓపెన్ చేసి రియాక్షన్ విత్ ఆక్సిడేషన్ రియాక్షన్ రాసింది చూడండి HCl KI
yes, sir.
ఆక్సిడేషన్ రియాక్షన్ HCl KI బెంజీన్ SF4 NO NO2 ఓకే NO2 అండ్ BCl3
BCl3
BCl3, no?
Yes, sir.
DCl3. You put one more there. Ammonia also add the ammonia. After DCl3 add ammonia, you take ammonia reaction with argon. Last reaction add the just one certain thing. Argon F4 with ammonia. With ammonia. 6NH3. Oxidizing. Ammonia is oxidized to N2. NH4 here plus 0. The ammonia is oxidized to N2. This reaction is the same, remember. Right, next, open your xenon F6. Under xenon F6, last reaction. Under xenon F6, reaction NaNO3, you know?
Yes, sir.
Right? We add two more reactions missing there. Oxidation reaction. Just two seconds, sir. Little space. Chinna place, sir. After the reaction with NaNO3, NaNO3 completed. Right. Oxidation reactions, right. Oxidation reactions. HCl to Cl2. Two seconds, sir. Not hexafluoride, HCl, BCl2, 6HF, and you know, HCl to Cl2. Here also again, ammonia to N2. Here also ammonia to N2. This also can oxidize. Not hexafluoride. N2 plus, see, ammonia to N2. Here, that's all. Ammonia to N2. Here also, ammonia to N2. We did not take a point, we did not accept a point. Right. We did not oxygen, we completed. Now, we did not dioxide dichloride. We did not dioxide dichloride. Xenon dioxide dioxide preparation. Preparation. One. Zero oxygen chloride with water. Under hydrolysis. Zero oxygen chloride plus H2O. Xenon. F2 plus 2HF. Next, we're on OF4 with SiO2. OF2 plus SiO4. Right. We're on O3 with. We're on OF4. We're on O3 with. We're on OF4. Single addition part of the reading. Single. Addition product. Single addition product to get. There is no byproduct like that. Only single addition. Here I think that we are correct. We don't have three. We don't have OF. Red arrow. 2 ion yes, 4 oxygen yes, 4 yes. Single addition product. In some of the reactions you only single addition product. That also particularly you have to remember. They are giving 4 options and which of the following leads to produce a single addition product. Like that. Okay, no? Right. They're actually listable compound. There are no much important properties for this. Then what we take directly, we go for structural hybridization. Come on. They're on O2F2 structure. O2F2 structure. Tell me directly. Hybridization, geometry, lone pairs, excited state, 5 marks. Two minutes time, come on, do it all of you. Shivani Papani, are you there in the class? Shivani.
Yes, sir.
Right. 2 minutes time. Right. Ready, come on. Giovanni, can you?
No.
You're not ready?
No, sir.
Okay, leave it. Renu Sri, can you?
Sir, 1 minute, sir.
Oh. Anthony, can you? Are you there in the class?
Yes, sir.
Come on, try. Can you answer?
Sir, SP3D.
SP3D. Okay, good. Next, geometry.
Trigonal bipyramid.
Okay, please. Hello, what is the geometry? Any other?
Seesaw. Seesaw.
Seesaw.
Seesaw.
Seesaw. Come on, lone pairs, Mr. Anthony.
Sir, one lone pair.
One lone pair. Excited state.
Sir, one.
First,
sir.
In the name of bonds are law. How many bonds are there, Mr.?
These are three.
In the name of bonds are law. How many bonds are there?
Six or nine.
Anthony.
Six, sir.
Six to ten.
Three, sir.
Third excited.
Third excited. Come on, 5 bonds, Mr. Anthony.
Two, sir.
2 5 bonds. What type of 5 bonds?
Sir, P pi, D pi.
Huh? Correct, you know.
P pi, D pi.
D to P. D orbital of xenon, P orbital of xenon. D P.
Yes, sir.
These are the questions that are asked. That is given which of the following is actually correct statement. All questions are said. Where are the other ones? This analysis they are giving in the exam. This analysis nobody can do. It's very difficult. None can do it, very difficult. Ila chestane meeku asalu emothe raadu. Come on, next. There are also tetrafluoride. Structure rasukovali, rasukovali. Structure endi. Seesaw. configuration. You know, it's a fluoride partial hydrolysis, XR. But you know this partial hydrolysis, just a very little hydrolysis, partial hydrolysis. Partial hydrolysis. You know, hexafluoride. Very limited hydrolysis. If you are leaving it, it will be again further undergoing hydrolysis. Then one step, you know, OFO plus 2HF. Second, you know, hexafluoride, SiO2, before we remember, whatever the way you know, hexafluoride react with water, similarly react with SiO2. One step, you know, hexafluoride, SiO2, 2, you know, OF4 plus SiF4. One step. Second step, third step, here also. Second step, third step. With water, it has the same reactions. Repeatedly, I say, I am saying, reaction with this water, reaction with silica, you know, example, same reactions. Next up, you know, mercury with, you know, hexafluoride. You know, mercury with, you know, hexafluoride. Again, single addition product. Single addition product. Single addition product. Single addition product again. Not that in a stable compound, therefore. Structure again, you know, OF4. You know, OF4. Do it up your 2 minutes time, hybridization, geometry. Updated this one. Updated?
Yes, yes, sir.
Right. Hybridization, geometry. Lone pairs, existing, 5 months. Do it, 2 minutes time. I am Kaushik, are there in the class? Kaushik, I am Kaushik.
Yes, sir.
Kaushik?
Yes, sir.
Are there in the class?
Yes, sir.
Right, right. 2 minutes time, do it. All of you do it. Kaushik, can you see? Got it?
Sir, hybridization
sp3d2. sp3d2, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, go sp3d2, right? Ah,
geometry square pyramidal.
Square pyramidal, go. Okay, go. Don't break.
Don't know, sir.
One page. What's your one page?
One, sir.
Third.
Three.
Third, 4 plus 2 bonds, 4 plus 2. Third and second state. 5 bonds?
1, sir.
1. Type of 5 bond?
D pi,
P pi, P pi.
Huh?
D pi, P pi.
D pi,
P pi.
Only D pi, P pi. SP3 gala. P I pi the gala. There is no chance for P. D2 P only. As you said, same pyramid. Right. Right, 0, 1, 3, F2, the next one. Submitted.
Yes, sir.
Right, 0, 1, 3, F2. Preparation. You don't explore any. You don't go far. You don't have three of two. You don't have three of two. Plus, they don't pull up four. Four, they have two, they don't pull up four. Six long, they don't have six. Okay, I didn't know here. They don't have support. They don't have support, they don't have pull up four. Right? Right, these also not very really important and stable compound. They don't intermediate compounds only. Intermediate, while the different reactions you are getting in the middle, these are the products. So, xenon, O3, EF2, do it again, structure and average, you know, 2 minutes time. 2 minutes time. Mallika ready, you are there in the class? Mallika ready. Yes? Mallika ready. No, Aleva. Bharat ready. Bharat ready, are they? Raja Sravan.
Sir.
Raja Sravan is there?
Yes, sir.
Come on, try, mister. Try, 2 minutes time. Raja Sravan, got it completed?
Sir, hybridization
SP3D.
SP3? SP3D.
Right, geometry?
Trigonal bipyramid also.
Lower trigonal bipyramid. Lower planes?
Zero, sir.
Zero, good. Excited state?
Excited state.
చెక్ చేయి బాండ్స్ ఏమైనా ఇందులో బాండ్స్ చూడు బాండ్స్ నెంబర్ ఆఫ్ బాండ్స్ ఎనీబడి Come on, get on oxychlorides, next. Get on oxides, next. Get on oxides. Get on fluorides, get on oxychlorides, get on oxides now. Get on oxides. Xenon dioxide preparation. Preparation many metals. Xenon hexafluoride on complete hydrolysis. Complete. Complete hydrolysis. Same reaction with silica also, no? They're not extra for it, it's silica. Silica. You know, tetrafluoride on hydrolysis. You know, tetrafluoride with water. Tetrafluoride also. With water. F2O. I given two reactions, half mole reaction and a full mole reaction. Either you can write with 12 moles, you can write with 6 moles also. Right. 2, xenon 3 plus 4 xenon plus 24 HF plus 3 O2. We don't have to go to with water. Xenon F2O2 with water, xenon O2F2 with again silica. So, visible this one? Is it ready here?
Yes, sir.
Visible? Right. The silica also. Same reaction, no? So, Explosive in nature. It is explosive. Next. With water. With the water, don't wait for a while. With water. With water it produces weakly acidic solution. Weakly acidic solution, 3H2O. In a reading word, XY, xenon, O6, minus, plus, H plus. So, we actually with the water undergoes partial hydrolysis produce weakly acidic solution. Weakly acidic solution. The same xenon O3 with alkali undergo complete hydrolysis. With alkali, take any alkali like sodium hydroxide writing in the wall. Xenon O3 with alkali. With alkali producing sodium xenate, you get first. Sodium xenate, see the word. Many H, xenon O4. Any H, xenon O4, this you can call it or xenon, right? Sodium xenate, we call sodium xenate. Sodium xenate. Sodium xenate, you're getting. This particular sodium xenate further undergoes reaction with what NaOH, the same alkali, the sodium xenate, the same alkali undergoes DPN, produce sodium perxenate. Sodium perxenate, see the word. Any H, xenon, O4, xenon, O4, with the, again, alkali, the same alkali, undergo DPN, disproportionation, produce sodium perxenate. So, Na4, xenon, O6, plus xenon. Here, xenon is got plus 6, here, xenon is got plus 8. Here xenon actually becoming zero. So xenon is undergoing DPN, oxidation, reduction, and again you are getting O2 plus followed by 2H2O. Last year, this is the question in IIT Advanced. Not this year, last year. Last year, this is the question in IIT Advanced. This xenon O3 with alkali undergoing partial hydrolysis, producing X compound. X compound, the same alkali, undergoes DPN to produce Y compound. Along with Y compound, how many gaseous products are generated? Two gaseous products. This is the entire type of question. How many gaseous products are generated? How many? That is the number. The number is given in the form of entire type of question. Two gaseous products are generated. This is the question last year, IIT Advanced. Right. Why crystalline solid? Why crystalline solid? Explosive nature. Explosive nature. Next. With water it produces weakly acidic solution. Weakly acidic solution. Weakly acidic. acidic solution, weakly acidic solution, acidic solution, right, next, with alkali, next, with alkali, it produces sodium zinate. This sodium zinate in the same alkali undergo this proportionation, undergo this proportionation, produce sodium perxenate, along with the liberation of two gaseous products, xenon and O2, gaseous products, xenon and O2. Take it, xenon O3 plus NaOH, sodium zinate. This you can also write ionic form. I am writing this ionic form. H xenon O4 minus. Don't come close. That is simply zinate ion. This is sodium zinate. This is what is zinate ion. Zinate ion. This sodium zinate is alkali producing. This is sodium oxidation. Sodium zinate or zinate ion, sodium perxenate are anion amidate. Xenon O6 minus 4. All zinate ion. Perxenate ion. This is xenon oxalic acid plus 6. Xenon oxalic acid plus 6. Zinate ion, polyzinate ion. Zinate xenonic plus 6. Zinate xenonic water, perxenate xenonic plus 6. This is the question appeared. How many gaseous products? Completed, shall I remove this? Completed.
Yes, sir.
This is very important reaction. This is appeared last year. I had advanced. This is the question. I had advanced. Come on, structure, ground O3. rate, loan rates, exit state, 5 marks. Good, structured evaluation. All of you, try. Shashidhar Kumar, are you there in the class? Shashidhar?
Sir, sir.
Right, come on.
SP3, sir.
Getting on? Come on. Correct, Ali. Come on.
SP3.
Right, SP3.
I don't know geometry.
What are your geometry?
Trigonal pyramidal.
Pyramids.
Pyramidal.
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 Only pyramidal.
Loan
page.
One loan. Exit
state.
Third exit.
5 bonds.
3.
What type of 5 bonds?
D5.
Zero-net oxide. Right, preparation. Sodium percentage, NaO4, 0.06. Barium percentage, Ba2, 0.06. With sulfuric acid. Great, second average, all of you. Devanpalli Satvik, you are there in the class? Satvik, Devanpalli. Hey, Mr., you are there or not? Amsini, you are there in the class? Amsini? Vityashri,
yes.
Come on, answer. Vityashri, you are there in the class?
Yes, sir.
Right, right. Come on, got it.
SP3 hybridization.
Good, SP3. Good, come on now. SP3.
Tetrahedral.
Right. Don't mix.
Zero lone pair.
Right, next. So this thing. Extra state. Extra state.
Four, sir.
Fourth one. Five bonds.
Four.
Type of five bonds.
D by P.
Right. Next, clathrate compounds, clathrate compounds are cage compounds are host-destiny compounds. Host-destiny compounds. Clathrate compounds, cage compounds, host-destiny compounds. Yes, compounds. Okay. Clathrate compounds, cage, then we call panjara sammelanam, panjara. Then host guest, Atithi Atithya, Sammelanam. Atithi Atithya, host guest. So, clathrate compound. What are clathrate compound, cage compound, host guest compound? Okay. Any suitable organic solvent. Either you take any organic solvent which can form intermolecular hydrogen bonding. That should be capable of forming intermolecular hydrogen bonding. So, any suitable organic compound which can form intermolecular hydrogen bonding. So, suitable organic solvent or inorganic solvent, whether it may be inorganic solvent, any suitable organic solvent or inorganic solvent, when cooled up, solidified, in presence of noble gases, like it may be argon, the krypton, or the xenon. So any organic or inorganic solvent, any suitable organic or inorganic solvent, which are capable of forming intermolecular hydrogen bonding, and cooled, solidified, in presence of noble gases like argon, krypton, xenon, in the solid solvent, the intermolecular spaces occupied by either of these gases, argon or the krypton or the xenon, producing special type of compounds known as clathrate compounds, cage. You see what cage? Solid solvent acts as a cage. Into the cage, these are actually occupying. Therefore, these are known as cage compounds and host guest compound. The solvent is the host and the noble gas atom is the guest. Therefore, host guest compound. So, any suitable organic or inorganic solvent, cooled, solidified under very high pressure, the presence of argon, krypton, xenon, intermolecular spaces occupied by this particular the noble gas atoms and forming special type of compounds known as lipid compounds, cage compounds, or host guest compounds. See, first thing, the cage formation. The cage formation, ice also. Whenever you are making the liquid water into ice is nothing but a cage type of compound. Cage type of lattice is generated. The cage formation in the solid solvent is not only intermolecular bonding. Look here. Water molecule and another water molecule and another water molecule like this. So this is actually the structure of ice. This is actually the structure of ice. In the case of ice, the water molecules are held by this particular hydrogen bonding. So therefore, ice occupies greater value. Therefore, ice floats on water. Ice floats on water because ice is less denser, more value because of formation of intermolecular spaces like this. So in like this, as it means water, ready solvent, you are solidifying. This type of intermolecular spaces are generated. This body intermolecular spaces, the noble gas atoms are occupying. Either it may be argon or the krypton, any other noble gas, but not helium and neon. Helium and neon cannot form any clathrate. Either argon or krypton, xenon, occupying the intermolecular spaces, producing special type of compounds, what are called clathrate compounds, cage compounds, host guest compounds. So the cage formation is due to intermolecular hydrogen bonding. First point. Second, the clathrate compound formation. The clathrate compound formation is due to, this is weak attraction force, weak van der Waals force of attraction between noble gas atom and solvent molecule. Solvent molecule to the noble gas atom, a weak van der Waals force of attraction thing. This particular van der Waals force of attraction, what to call? This particular van der Waals force of attraction, what to call? This one, dipole induced dipole interaction. Dipole induced dipole interaction. It is due to the clathrate compound formation due to weak van der Waals force of attraction, or it is due to dipole induced dipole interaction. Dipole induced dipole interaction. Next. In the formation of clathrate compounds, there is no formation of any new chemical bonds. See, the cage formation, what I said, hydrogen bonding not a chemical bond. And the clathrate compound formation, the weak van der Waals force. Van der Waals force or dipole induced dipole interaction is not a chemical bond. So, clathrate compounds are formed, but this formation is not only due to any chemical bond formation. So that the clathrate, during the formation of clathrate compounds, No new chemical bonds are formed. There is no formation of any new chemical bond. Hydrogen bond, not a chemical bond. Van der Waals force, not a chemical bond. Therefore, by the formation of clathrate compound, there is no formation of any new chemical bonds. Next, look here. General chemical formula of this particular clathrate. General chemical formula. NHMG. NHMG. Come on. NH stands for number of host molecules. Number of host molecules means solvent. Number of host molecules means one solvent molecule. Whatever the solvent you are using, that is solvent molecule. Come on. MG. MG stands for number of guest atoms. Number of guest atoms means this particular argon, krypton, xenon. Number of guest atoms, argon, krypton, xenon, these are what noble gas atoms like argon, krypton, and xenon. Number of guest atoms, argon, krypton, xenon. Need not be argon, krypton, xenon. Even nitrogen molecule, even oxygen molecule, even chlorine molecule can also form clathrate compound. But we are discussing under zero group. Then it is called argon, krypton, xenon, or water. Guest atoms. Host is what solvent, guest is water, noble gas atoms. Next. Here, helium and neon cannot form clathrates. Remember, helium and neon are very small. They cannot exert any van der Waals force on the solid molecule. Moreover, intermolecular space is very big. And helium and neon atoms are very small. Therefore, they cannot fit into the intermolecular space. Therefore, helium and neon do not form any clathrate compounds. Next, the stability of clathrates proportional to atomic size. Bigger the atomic size, tightly fix here. Without atomic size, it can tightly fix in the intermolecular space. Therefore, order of stability, xenon clathrate is more stable than, krypton clathrate is more stable than, argon clathrate. This is what the order of stability of clathrate compound. Order of stability of clathrate compounds. Right. Tomorrow I'll repeat all this once again. Tomorrow I'll be the most. Right. Getting to tomorrow.
Sir, okay. Sir, once can you give reaction of H2O with XeO3, sir?
H2O with
XeO3. Once can you give that reaction, sir? Like your update very quickly, sir.
XeO3 plus H2O,
huh? Yes, sir.
H5, XeO6 minus plus H plus. Better. H5 xenon 6 minus H plus. Okay.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
I'll repeat all this tomorrow once again. Right. Vishal.